Okay, for this project, you're going to need your M hook or your 9mm crochet hook, and you're also going to need your G hook or 4mm crochet hook, and a pair of scissors, and your tapestry needle. And you're also going to need just regular sewing needle with some white thread. And here's the face that we're going to make. So for the eyes, I use the Suncatcher craft eyes, and they have the safety snap on the back. And you're also going to need, I used favorite findings buttons, two of the pink buttons for the cheeks, the rosy cheeks. And then I just had a red button. So if you have any red button that you want for the nose, you can go ahead and get that also. And you're also going to need some jingle bells if you want that for the, that goes around the neck. And for yarn, I used a soft brown. I just had a bulk tan brown that I used for the main body. And then you're going to need some white. I'm just using the Value Craft Smart white yarn. And then I also have some Red Heart Jumbo Saver black yarn for the mouth. And then this is just a darker brown that you're going to need. And I used, this is Lion's Brand. Vanna's Lion's Brand is really soft, but you can use any brown, darker brown yarn that you want to use. And then for the neck, around the neck, you're going to use, for the leash, you're just going to use a red. And I'm just using the Red Heart Super Saver, and this is cherry red. All right, so we're going to start with the head first. Go ahead and get your N or 9mm crochet hook, and we're going to start with the magic circle. You're just going to take the yarn and drape it across your four fingers, and then you're going to use your thumb to stabilize and wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers, and then just hold the yarn in place with the pinky and the thumb. Just take your N hook and go under the two loops. You're going to grab the yarn and just bring it under the two loops, and then you're going to yarn over again. Turn the hook upside down and go through that loop for your slip knot. And now we're going to do six single chains into the magic circle. So you're just going to go under, yarn over. You have two loops on the hook, yarn over, and then go through both loops on the hook for one single chain. Two single chains. Three single chains, four single chains, five, and the last one, six single chains. And then just take your forefinger and thumb, and you're going to grab the bottom of the six single chains that you just completed in the magic circle, and then you see these two strands on the opposite side, you're going to pull on one. If it doesn't move, let go and pull on the other one. This one's moving, so I'm going to go ahead and pull on it. Oop, actually, it's not. So I'm going to pull on the other one. Don't pull it too tight. You can always close it more later. And then grab the loose yarn in and pull on that. And your work should look like this. And now you're going to do two single chains into each stitch. So in that first stitch, you're going to do two single chains in that first stitch. So yarn over, two loops on your hook, yarn over and go through both loops on the hook for one, two, and then in the next stitch, you're going to do two more, one, two, for four, and then we're going to do two single chains in every stitch around. One, two, six, one, two for eight, one, two for 10, and then the last two, one and two. So now you're just going to get your yarn marker, and then just put it right where you left off. And now we're going to do increase rounds. So now you're going to do one single chain in the next stitch and then two single chains in the second stitch. So in the next stitch, you're going to do one single chain. And then in the next stitch, you're going to do two single chains in the same stitch. One and two. So go ahead and repeat that pattern. One single chain in one stitch and two single chains in the next stitch. And do that all the way around back to your yarn marker. And then come back and I'll show you the next step. Okay, you should be back. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move that up to where you left off. And we're going to do another increase round. You're going to do one single chain in the next two stitches and then two single chains in the third stitch. So in the next stitch, you're going to do one single chain, second stitch, one single chain. And then in the third stitch, you're going to do two single chains, one, two. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to your yarn marker and then come back and I'll show you the next step. All right, so this should be the last increase round for the head. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And now you're going to do one single chain in the next three stitches and then do two single chains in the fourth. So in the next stitch, you do one single chain. And then second stitch, one single chain. Third stitch, one single chain. And then in the fourth stitch, you're going to do two single chains in the same stitch. One, and then two. So go ahead and repeat this pattern all the way back to the yarn marker and then come back and I'll show you the next step. All right, so now we're going to do a slip stitch. Go ahead and go into the next stitch and then you're going to yarn over and then pull through both loops on the hook. And then we're going to finish off. Go ahead and yarn over and then pull enough for sewing. And pull a little bit more. And then go ahead and cut it. Now you're going to need one more of these, just like this. And then go ahead and start on a third one. And then on the third one, don't slip stitch and finish off. And that we're going to start from there to start the body. Okay, so we're back. We're going to be making the body. So you should have finished one single chain in three stitches and then two single chains in the fourth. So now I'll go ahead and move your yarn marker up and we're going to do another increase round and we're going to do one single chain in the next four stitches and then two single chains in the fifth. So in the next stitch, you're going to do one single chain, second stitch, one single chain, third stitch, one single chain, and the fourth stitch, one single chain. And the fifth stitch, you're going to do two single chains in the same stitch. One, and then two. So go ahead and repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker and then come back and I'll show you the next step. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and do another increase round. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up to the next row. And we're going to do one single chain in the next five stitches and then two single chains in the sixth. So in the next stitch, you're going to do one single chain. Second stitch, one single chain. Third stitch, one single chain. Fourth stitch, one single chain. And the fifth stitch, one single chain. And then in the sixth stitch, you're going to do two single chains in the same stitch. One, and then two. So go ahead, repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker and then come back and I'll show you the next step. All right, so you should be back. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. This is going to be our last increase round for the body. So we're going to do one single chain in the next six stitches and then do two single chains in the seventh stitch. So in the next stitch, you're going to do one single chain, second stitch, one single chain, third stitch, one single chain, fourth stitch, one single chain, fifth stitch, one single chain, and then in the sixth stitch, we're going to do one single chain, and the seventh stitch, we're going to do two in the same stitch, so one and two. So go ahead and repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker, and then come back and I'll show you the next step. All right,
so now we're going to go ahead and do a slip stitch into the next stitch. So go ahead and go into the next stitch, yarn over, and then just pull the yarn through both loops on the hook.
And then we're going to finish off. Go ahead and yarn over and then pull through, and then leave enough yarn to sew your body to the other side. You should have two of the body. So you're going to make two of these. And you're also going to need the white center. So you're going to do the white center the same way with a magic circle with six single chains. And then you're going to do the two single chains in each stitch for 12. And then you're going to do an increase up to one single chain and two single chains, two stitches, one single chain and two stitches, and then two single chains in the third. So go ahead and make your body the center of the body, and then you're going to need two of these, and then come back and I'll show you how to do the arms and legs. Okay, so the arms and legs, you're going to need the white arm, and they're all going to be made the same way, so you're going to make four of them. But we're going to start with a magic circle with the white yarn. So go ahead and take the yarn and drape it over your four fingers, and then stabilize with your thumb and wrap it around your two middle fingers twice, and then hold it with your pinky and your thumb. And then you're going to take your end hook, crochet hook, go under the two loops, go ahead and grab the yarn and bring it under, and then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down and go through that loop for your slip knot. And then you're going to do six single chains into the magic circle. So you're going to go under the two loops, yarn over, two loops on your hook, yarn over, go through both for one single chain, two single chains, three single chains, four, five, and six. Go ahead and take your forefinger and your thumb and hold it at the base. And then you have the two loops on the side. You're going to pull on one of them to close up the magic circle. Don't pull it too tightly. And then take your other strand and pull on that. And then we're going to do two single chains into each stitch. So in the first stitch, you're going to do two single chains. One, two, and then in the next stitch, you're going to do two more. One, two for four. Next stitch, two more. One, two for six. Next stitch, two more. One, two for eight. Next stitch, one, two for 10, and then next stitch, one, two for 12. Now you're just going to get a yarn marker to help keep track of the rows, and you can see the large hole in the center. You can turn over and just pull on the strand of yarn, and then that closes up your magic circle. So go ahead and get your yarn marker. Put it where you left off, and now you're just going to do one round of single chain in each stitch with the white yarn. So in the next stitch, you're going to do one single chain. So every stitch, you're going to do one single chain all the way back to the yarn marker. Just one single chain all the way around. And then we're going to change colors. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So one single chain, every stitch, all the way back to the yarn marker. Okay, so I'm almost back to the yarn marker. And then what you're going to do, once you've reached your yarn marker, you're going to go into the next stitch, and then pull up, yarn over and pull up. Now you have two loops on the hook, and you're going to grab the same color as the body of your reindeer.
And then you're going to take the yarn and you're going to loop it through both loops. And then you're going to do a single chain. See, I'm holding the yarn over and pull through the loop for a single chain. And then you're going to take your work, turn it over, and you're going to cut your previous yarn or the white yarn. And then you're just going to tie a knot on the back. And then I usually just tie it 3 times. And then you don't have to worry about burying your yarn work because you're just going to stick it in the center of the arm. So now, go ahead and take your yarn marker. You can move it up to help you keep track. And we're going to do 1 single chain into every stitch around. So just 1 single chain all the way around. And you're going to do that for 3 rows. So go ahead and do that and come back after 3 rows, and then I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so you should have finished your 3 rows. You have 1, 2, and 3. Now we're going to go ahead and do a slip stitch. So go ahead and go into the next stitch, yarn over, and pull through both loops on the hook. And we're going to go ahead and finish off, yarn over, and pull through the loop on the hook, and leave enough yarn for sewing onto the hot pad. So you're going to need 4 of these. So go ahead and make 4 of these and then come back and I'll show you how to make the reindeer collar. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to make the reindeer collar. What you're going to do is take your red and then you're just going to loop the yarn over itself and then take your end hook and then go through the loop and then you're going to hold the loop with your middle finger and your thumb and then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down and go through that loop for your slip knot. And now you're going to chain 8. So yarn over, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then you're going to hold on to that last stitch you did because we're going to chain 2 for your first half double crochet. So 1, 2. And then you're going to yarn over. And you're going to do your second half double crochet in the 3rd stitch, the one you were holding, the 3rd stitch from the hook. Go on in there, yarn over. You have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and go through all 3. And that's your second half double crochet. And you're going to do half double crochet all the way back. So yarn over into the next stitch. Yarn over. And then yarn over and go through all 3 for the 3rd half double crochet. And then just keep doing half double crochet all the way back. And then when you reach the end, come back and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so you should have reached the end and your work looks like this. We're going to go ahead and finish off. Go ahead and yarn over and pull through. And then just pull enough yarn to sew onto the second one that you're going to make. So you're going to need 2 of them. Go ahead and make your second one. And then what you're going to do is take your little bell that you have and then just take your sewing needle and white thread. And then you're just going to sew it on to one of the pieces. And then you're going to take your tapestry needle after you're finished making your second part of the reindeer collar. And then just take your tapestry needle and put the longer end of the yarn on, and then you can go ahead and tie a knot with one of your other, on the other part of the half of the reindeer collar, you can tie a knot. And then just make sure it lines up with your other collar. And then you're just going to take your tapestry needle and then you're just going to sew around. And you can try to bury your yarn ends into the center too, if you like. Or you can just bury them when you're done, whatever's easiest for you. So then you just take your tapestry needle and then you're just going to go superficially around and just sew the pieces together. You're just going to sew it all the way around. And then when you're done, come back and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to do the antlers. So you're going to need your darker brown yarn that you're going to be using. And you're also going to need your G-hook or a 4mm crochet hook. And we're going to do the magic circle. So go ahead and take the yarn and drape it across your four fingers. And then also loop it twice around your two middle fingers. And then take your G-hook and go under the two loops, yarn over. And then you're going to yarn over again. Turn the hook upside down and just go through that loop on the hook for your slip knot. And then you're going to do six single chains into the magic circle. So you're going to yarn over, two loops on your hook, yarn over and go through both loops for your first single chain. Two, three, four, five, and six. And then go ahead and take your forefinger and thumb, grip it at the base of the six single chains, and then you have the two loops on the side. Go ahead and pull on one of them to close it. Don't pull it too tightly. Grab the other loose end of the yarn and pull that to close the magic circle. And then we're going to do two single chains into each stitch. So in the next stitch, you're going to do two single chains. One, two, and you're going to do two single chains all the way around. One, two for four. One, two for six. One, two for eight, one, two for 10, and then the last two, one and two. And then go ahead and get your yarn marker and put it right where you left off. And now you're going to do one single chain in every stitch. And you're going to do that for four rows for the short antler. And then you're going to do it for 10 rows for the large antler. So you're going to need two small ones and then two large ones for the antlers. The small one has four rows and the large one has 10 rows. So come back when you're done and then I'll show you how to put the reindeer together. Okay, so before I show you how to make the ear, I'm just going to show you how to sew on the small antler onto the big antler. So you're just going to take your tapestry needle and attach the brown, darker brown thread to it. If you left a long enough strand off the smaller antler, you can use that. And just go into the bigger antler. And then you're going to come up on the other side into the smaller antler. And then you're going to go into the smaller antler and then go into the bigger antler into the front. And then you're just going to keep sewing the smaller antler on in that fashion and then tie a knot and it's going to go onto your potholder like this. And then just come back when you've finished doing that and then I'll show you how to make the ear. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to make the ear and you're going to need two of them. We're going to do the magic circle. Go ahead and drape the white yarn across your four fingers and then loop it twice around the middle fingers and then hold it with your pinky and thumb. And then take your G hook, go under the two loops of the magic circle, and you're going to yarn over and pull the loop back under, and then yarn over and go through that loop for your slip knot. And now loosely, we're going to do three single chains into the magic circle. So you're going to go under the magic circle, yarn over, and then yarn over and go through for first single chain, and see how I'm making kind of loose under. Yarn over for two, then under, and yarn over for three. And then you're just going to take your forefinger and thumb and go to the bottom of the three single chains and then pull on one of the strands on the other side of the magic circle and then pull on the loose yarn strand. And then you have three loose single chains on your magic circle. You're going to do two single chains into each. So in the next stitch, you're going to do two single chains. One, two, and then in the next stitch, you're going to do two single chains. One, two, and then the last stitch, you're also going to do two single chains into that last stitch. One, and two, for a total of six. Now you're going to get your yarn marker, and you're going to do one single chain in the next stitch, and then two single chains in the next stitch. So in the next stitch, we'll do one single chain. And then in the next stitch, we're going to do two single chains in the same stitch. One, two, next stitch, one single chain. And then in the next stitch, we're going to do two single chains. One, two, next stitch, one single chain. And then the last stitch, we're going to do two single chains, one and two. Now you're going to do one single chain around for four rows. So we're going to go into next single chain, it's one, and you can also turn it inside out now. And it might be a little bit easier to do your rows and to see your rows. And you can use this as your yarn marker. So one single chain into each stitch around. And you're going to do that for four rows. And then come back and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so you should have completed four rows. One, two, three, four. So now we're going to do a slip stitch into the next stitch. Just go into your next stitch. Yarn over and then pull the yarn through both loops on the hook, and then you're going to yarn over and just pull a little bit of yarn for burying into the work. And then you can just tuck the middle yarn into the ear. And now we're going to do the border around the ear. So the stitches aren't really easy to see, so we're going to just go in those in between those stitches wherever we're able to. So go ahead and join, put your hook through the side of the ear, and then grab the color of the body, and then you're just going to loop the yarn and bring it through the ear and just leave enough in the back for tying your knot, and go ahead and do a single chain, and then turn your work over. And then you're just going to tie a knot. And here I'm just going to tie two. And then you're going to go ahead and chain two for your first half double crochet. One, two. And then you're going to yarn over and you're going to bury your yarn end as you work. And then you're going to go into right next to where you did your first half double crochet and just do another half double crochet, yarn over, three loops on your hook, yarn over and go through all three. And you're just going to keep doing half double crochets along the edge of the ear. And you're burying the yarn in as you go. And then when you get to the tip of the ear, you're going to do 3 half double crochets into the tip. There's 1. Two. And 3. And then you're going to do 2 half double crochet in the first stitch along the other side. So 1, 2, and then you can just do 1 half double crochet all along the side back to the end, and then you just finish off. And then come back and I'll show you how to put together the reindeer. Okay, the first thing you're going to do is just take one of your body halves and then take the white center of the body and then just take a tapestry needle. And then sew with the white yarn, sew the middle white portion onto the body. Okay, so now you're going to want to do the face. And if you haven't made your white snout, it's just the white yarn with your G-hook. And you're going to do a magic circle with 6 single chains, and then 2 single chains in each of the stitches around the magic circle for a total of 12. And then only 1 increase with 1 single chain in the next stitch, and then 2 single chains in the next stitch all the way around. Then you're going to slip stitch and finish off, and then take your red button and sew that onto your snout, and then go ahead and embroider with your tapestry needle and your black yarn. You're just going to go and sew a smiley mouth right under the nose, and you're going to follow the curve as you do it, and then you can go ahead and sew the snout onto your head with your tapestry needle and the white yarn. And sew that on, and then you can make sure, you may want to put your eyes in first before you put the snout, because my snout was a little bit more towards the left eye, but still looks cute. But you may want to sew your snout on first and then place your eyes. And you can see how I put the snout close to the bottom edge, and then the 2 eyes pretty level with the snout. And then right under the eyes, I just put the 2 cheek buttons. And then when you're done with that, you're just going to take the other side of your body, and then we're going to sew those together. Actually, it's the 2 halves of the head. You're going to sew those together. So you just take your tapestry needle and then take the same color. Either use the yarn if you left enough for sewing, or get your own yarn threaded on. And then you're just superficially going to go into the stitches. The top stitch, and then just sew the 2 pieces together. And you're just going to go back and forth, and you're going to sew both pieces together of the head, and you're going to do the same thing for the body, and then come back and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and sew on our antlers, and just make sure that you have your antlers lined up so that they meet each other in the middle, and then you just take your tapestry needle, and then you're just going to sew it on to the head, and you're just going to go in and out and through the body, through the head and to the back, and then you're just going to go up into the antler. And you're just going to keep sewing it on, and then do the same thing. Go in the antler first, and then go into the body. And then go up into the antler. And then just keep sewing it on, and then tie a knot. And then do the same thing for the other antler. Okay, so this is how your reindeer should be looking so far. And now we're going to do the ears. So we're going to actually use the white yarn to sew on the ears. So just take your loose ends that you have and you can bury them into your work. And then just cut that off. So all your ends are buried in the work. And then you're just going to sew the ears with the white yarn and your tapestry needle onto the sides of the reindeer, and then come back and then I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so this is how your reindeer should look at this time. And now we're going to do the reindeer collar. So you're just going to take the reindeer collar and the body that you've already sewn together, and you're just going to put the collar on that first stitch around. So that first stitch, you're just going to cover that first lip of that stitch, and then you're going to take your red yarn on your tapestry needle, and then you're going to come in through the back, and then you're just going to sew the bottom, leave enough on the back for tying your knot, and then you're just going to go across and stitch the bottom of the reindeer collar to that first stitch of the body, and then come back and then I'll show you how to attach the head. Okay, so this is how your work should look. You should have the bottom portion of the collar sewed onto the first row of the body, and now you're going to take the head and you're going to put it on front of the collar on that top row, and then just sew. Actually, you're going to take the same color as the head to sew the head onto the top row of the collar, and then come back and I'll show you the next step. So as you can see, I have the same color and I'm just going in and out with my tapestry needle and just sewing the head onto the collar. Okay, you should be back and should look like this. Should be sewn on already. So now you're just going to do your arms. You're going to sew your arms on close to the collar on the body. And then you're also going to sew the feet on the bottom and then come back and we'll see the finished product. Okay, and this is how your work should look. All done. I sewed the legs onto the body and then also the hands. And you have your head, and you are all finished.